Because I see lots of people with diabetes and I hear about lots of people suffering from it, and it is a huge, huge challenge, particularly diet type 2. So it is a theme that we're going to see if we can follow through for the whole week, fighting diabetes. Looking at type 2, it develops when the insulin-producing cells in the body are unable to produce enough, or when the insulin that is produced doesn't really work properly. Raga de Silva has type 2 diabetes and joins us now. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you, Eddie.
Well, I don't know, you know, we haven't spoken in what must be a year or so.
Yeah, I think it's been over a year now.
Well, how are you doing? How is the weight and how is the eating? Are you still putting too much spice in your food?
I'm putting a lot of spice in my food, but not much oil and butter. Spice is good.
So let's go back for the people that don't know. When were you diagnosed, Raga?
It was in 2012.
Okay, and did you feel, oh goodness, oh, it's just a minor inconvenience? How seriously did you take it?
Oh, I mean, what happened to me was pretty serious. I woke up one morning and I just couldn't see. So that was pretty serious. And I felt sick for a long, long time. I had extreme fatigue. And I just felt so unwell that I just didn't know what was happening to me. And it wasn't something that I had to take lightly.
No, not at all. And you know, blindness is one of the features. Losing a limb is another. I meet so many people say, Eddie, I'm diabetic, get me another brandy. And they think, oh, goodness gracious me. And so have you taken it seriously?
No, I have taken it very seriously. In fact, I took it so seriously that I made amazing, I think, I'll tell you, lifestyle changes. I retuned the way I thought about food. I retuned the way I thought about my health. I retuned the way I looked at, you know, activity and exercise. And I managed to reverse my diabetes.
Yeah, I was about to say it is possible. I've been reading lots and lots about how, you know, people who've been diagnosed have turned their life around and then it's gone. And then you kind of, you don't want to go back to the old ways. What sort of stuff have you done then?
Oh, I mean, I exercise quite a bit. I walk about, I can say about 42, 60 kilometers a week, which I know is not possible for many. I stay very active. I've changed the way I eat, my eating habits. So like we spoke about it last time, Eddie, if you remember, samosas and butter was what we...
Yeah, but they are nice, though. You missed them, don't you? You missed
no,
them.
I don't.
don't lie to me. You missed the samosa.
No, but when I miss them, I do have them. So it is an occasional, you know.
Ah, so it's a treat now as opposed to just being there every single day.
Exactly.
What about the oil, then? Are you cooking with oil or are you using, you know, lots of people now using extra virgin olive oil or coconut oil? Or what are you doing?
Yeah, I do use extra virgin oil. I do use coconut oil. So it is about making healthy choices. I don't use, and it doesn't matter actually what oil you use. I mean, of course, it has an impact, but it's just how much do you use? That's also, I mean, we tend to think that, you know, if you use extra oil, the food tastes extra good. And those are the kind of things we have to forget, you know, change.
If you're not, when my mum's not here, everything goes in. So it's an oven, it's baked, it's lots of that. We hardly use any oil at all. Mum's here now. Mum fries everything. Have you tried to baking and all of that kind of thing as opposed to using the oil at all?
I do a lot of baking. I do a lot of grilling. I do a lot of steaming. So those are little changes, and the food tastes as beautiful.
Doesn't it? I'm surprised. Yes. I was like, oh, that's going to taste horrible. I want my oil. And then And what about, Raga, now here's where you're going to let me down. I know where you're going to let me down. The portion sizes. Because you can't eat in the tray. Yeah, you can't have that big old plate that doesn't even fit it anywhere. You've got to get a smaller... Have you reduced your sizes yet, Raga?
Yeah, so I mean, this is exactly what I meant. You just reduce the portion size by, you know, using smaller plates. So when your plate is small, you don't fill it up as much. And the other thing is that you don't eat, like, 20 times a day. Or you don't eat three meals, which are so huge that you just can't get up. And
that's right. And then all I can hear is... which is Raga, who's fallen asleep because you've eaten too much and now you've fallen asleep.
Yes, Yes, exactly. And that is what used to happen to me 5 years ago.
One day, Rega, we are going to eat together, you and I. I'm going to keep you on as my number one diabetes person to help people. And I think you do fabulously every time you come. And I thank you, Rega, for taking it in fabulous spirit, as you always do. So there you have it, Rega de Silva there from North Finchley. I've spoken to her so many times. I enjoy it every single time. Please, just go onto the Diabetes UK website. Have a look. It's not about not cooking, it's not about not eating, it's not about not enjoying your food, it's about your health. Trust me when I tell you, it is hugely debilitating. There are so many people with diabetes, or some of them don't even know they've got it yet. So please, be very, very careful.